wasn't like the other one because you didn't take my face at all.
You know I am recording.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, so today we are going to join the two halves of the pickling crock. So this is the bottom that you have on.
Right, and I'm just doing, you know, the flip and score. Getting it.
And the bottom was not wired off.
It was not, because I may want to throw it a little bit, because usually they're not 100% straight between the two sections.
And if it is not attached to the bat well, you would want to put on your worms.
Oh, yeah, if it feels like it's going to come off. But if I would think with this thick as we're throwing these, they're not going to come off.
Yeah.
Because unless you got your bottom too thin. So now I'm just going to turn this over and score it. So I guess I should turn it.
And you're using that serrated.
Yeah. So anything that you have for slipping and scoring will work. You can even use an X-Acto knife. And now I'm just going to match it up. It's a little slippery.
So are you pressing the...
I'm pressing from the outside and kind of supporting it from the inside. And I'm just trying to line it up so it's completely lined up.
Ah.
And then I'm going to start just kind of pushing down.
So you just press the top out to fit first.
Yeah, if it's a little bit off. And then I just start pushing down to kind of join the two.
Okay. So just moving that clay down.
Yep, and I'll do the same thing on the inside once I get this down. We're just trying to create like a really strong attachment so it doesn't crack. And I'm going to do the same thing inside.
Do you mostly press from the top down?
I'm pressing from the top down. You could probably do it bottom up. It's just...
Yeah, I'm just wondering if that would...
Usually it's thicker on the top piece.
Ah.
You know, just because it was the bottom.
Oh, yeah, it was still on the bat and probably thicker.
Yeah, it's probably a little thicker.
So you have more stuff to move.
Yep. So then I'll just kind of run my fingers around it just to get an initial attachment. And then I'm going to actually add a coil, because I think everybody should probably add a coil for this one.
Okay.
Since it's your first crock. And I'm going to do one on the inside and one on the outside. So I just basically threw a hollow cylinder to get my coil.
And you could roll them out.
You could. Could easily. I was just being lazy. And this is pretty wet, so it's almost like adding slip.
And I'm going to come around your other side so they can kind of see what you're doing.
Okay. Whoa.
So
I'm just
kind of
pushing.
Over.
And because I threw it, it's really wet. It's almost like slip in a coil.
Ah.
So that's the add benefit, I guess, about doing the coil this way rather than rolling it out.
Yeah, because that dries it out just
the rolling.
Yeah, this
is
like rolling.
Really wet clay. Like just thrown clay.
Which will make it easier to blend it.
Yeah, because I'm going to take a rib to this as soon as I get it all. And doing this method, I actually haven't had, doing this for either moon jars or this, I haven't had any cracks. So.
Oh, excellent.
Since I started doing this. And then I'm going to just stand up and line this up on the inside. Because I want it on the inside too.
There you go.
Yeah, I'm just kind of adding it, and then I'll kind of smooth it into the joined section.
So you're just adding that coil right on the inside at the same seam.
And it's just going to give it some strength.
Yeah.
We you just kind of push it in, and then you can use a rib on the inside. We'll go rib to rib just to really cement that. So I'm going to put this rib on the inside and have this rib on the outside and just kind of...
So is your blue rib curved side out?
Yeah, curved side out right against that seam.
And then is that your wood rib?
Yep, wood rib right on the outside. And it's almost acting like a concrete spatula. You know, what do they call that when you make sidewalks?
There must be a name for it.
Yeah, I can't remember, but see, that's kind of just smoothing that.
Yeah, and that slip joins it all.
Yeah, and that seam is disappearing.
Yeah.
And then I might do that. All I'm trying to do is get that seam really tight. And now I'm going to let this sit once I do this before I do a final throw, just so that those joints can really marry each other, because if you can tell, it's a little bit off here, and I probably want to do one pull before I finish it.
Right now it's so wet with that seam that you probably pull it apart.
Yeah. So just let it sit, you know, if you're in the studio, let it sit for an hour or so, and then you can finish it. If you're going away for the night, just put a bag over it.
Okay.
And then come in and throw it the next day.
All right. We're done.
Okay.